This is Harry Davis from Mirror Fighting, joined by Solomon Dacres, who had a big part to play in Tyson Fury's fight camp against Francis Ngannou, who is also in action of his own the following month. So, Solomon, how are you doing?
Yeah, more good man yourself.
Good, thank you. So, obviously, I wanted to speak to you about we've got two big heavyweight fights coming up. But firstly, I'll go back to when I last spoke to you, which was 5 days before Fury and Ngannou, and I think a lot of us boxing fans were sort of had to eat our own words because we all thought it was going to be one-sided. I remember you sort of made the same prediction and no one really gave anything but a puncher's chance to Francis, and he sort of surprised us, didn't he?
Yeah, I mean, I was the same as everyone else. I didn't, like I say, just had the puncher's chance, but the performance wasn't what we thought from one Fury. But sometimes those MMA guys, they're very awkward. It's not like fighting a conventional boxer, so they can make things very awkward.
That's something you said too, is,
Yeah.
I pointed out, is like, look, it's not going to be a typical boxer's game plan. He might do some stuff that's sort of strange. And we saw that in like the final round with the Superman punch. But I believe you were there on fight night watching from ringside. And if you were you just as shocked as all of us?
Yeah, like obviously when he put him down, I was like, "Fucking hell," struck. Everyone was quite shocked, but watching the actual fight, there weren't loads going on. Fury was like nicking, pecking, and poking. I think after the knockdown, he thought, "If I gamble with anything, yeah, this guy got serious power, and he could put me down again." So he's pecking and poking, point scoring a bit. Ngannou had his little moments, and obviously, when he had a little moment, everyone focuses on that because they was expecting him to have no chance. So he had a few little flurries, and he's a very strong man. But yeah, man, very interesting fight.
Obviously, we're a couple months on now, but like you said, in the moment, maybe because no one expected him to do so well, people sort of thought, oh, he was robbed there. But I'm guessing you scored it for Fury. Do you remember exactly sort of how many rounds you actually gave Francis?
Yeah, I don't know about rounds, but I did think at the end, I thought he has won the fight because look at the majority of the rounds. He was winning it. There weren't much going on. He was winning them. He was fighting, pecking a few jabs, a couple of this, few bits of pressure. Nothing major was going on, but he was just winning a few rounds. Do you know what I mean?
So obviously we go from that fight, and then you're in action, I believe, the following month in Manchester, one against Michael Webster by majority decision, and now hoping to be back in. I believe you're back in the ring in next month. So what, just over a month now in Birmingham, right?
Yeah, back out March 16th in Birmingham. Got the show, like you said. I was just out then after that Fury fight, last minute one. Obviously, I just signed with Frank, new promoter. They give me opportunity there on 2 weeks' notice, and I couldn't really turn it down. I knew I wasn't quite prepared like I should have been, but I just took the fight, scraped the win, and we move on now with proper preparation to the March 16th, where should be, more like at my best than where I should be.
I remember speaking to you, and you said you wanted to be in action before Christmas. You were. Obviously, it was
Yeah.
a majority decision win. I think if I'm not mistaken, you got deducted a point in the 10th for, I believe it was like the forearm or something. That fight was a bit frustrating, and maybe next month hoping to put on a more decisive performance, if I'm right in saying that.
Yeah, definitely. It was not a good performance from myself. I just about nicked the fight, but I know I wasn't really training properly. I was away from my own coach for 6 weeks, and then I had 2 weeks' notice. I was just ticking over. Was it being a sparring partner, obviously, for Fury? Doing the 4 rounds, 6 rounds here, ticking over really. Not really preparing myself for a 10-round title fight, but I just had to take the opportunity as it comes with a new promoter, and just try to get myself out there and take a bit of a gamble. But something now that I know you can't take 10-round title fights on short notice, and you can't gamble with these fights because the opponents, they've got their own agenda, so you got to just be at your best, and that's what I'm going to be for my next one.
Obviously, what, just about 5 weeks away from that one now. When we spoke last time, you said, I don't know how much involvement I'll have if the Fury 6 fight's made, because obviously your orthodoxy is a southpaw. I'm guessing, has there been any sort of sparring? Have you been out in Saudi at all, or is it just all the focus been on your own fight?
No, just focus on my own stuff now, obviously. Yeah, like I say, he's just going to get all southpaws in. He's not going to get the orthodoxy in. He's fully focused. He's going to get all his sparring partners. He's got all southpaws in. He's going to be just, fully focused on the job at hand.
A lot has been made this week. A lot of comments from the likes of Johnny Nelson, and Tyson's been quiet. He usually goes quiet before a fight's right. He does these sort of social media blackouts and just dials himself in. But as someone who's you've been in since what I believe the Chisora trilogy camp, you sparred him. What have you sort of heard? I'm sure he's completely focused, and all these stuff about him being dropped and having a disastrous camp, I'm sure in your mind is nonsense, right?
Yeah, I mean, some you always get, big fights, and you always get these rumors someone's been dropped in sparring, this, that, and the other. I know I ain't been there, I don't know what's happened or anything, but rumors are rumors at the end of the day. It doesn't matter. Even if you do get put down in sparring, you'd rather get put down in sparring than in the ring on fight night, wouldn't you? It's all part of the preparation. So I don't really listen to these rumors and look into these kind of things. He's gonna be training very hard, and it's the performance on fight night that matters.
Something Johnny Nelson said when I spoke to him is Tyson's been uncharacteristically quiet for this one, and that could either be a good sign or a bad sign. He said it could mean he's really dialed in, or it could mean things aren't going as planned. He's not as confident. What do you think? Because he's always sort of been quiet. Like as I said, he doesn't usually post much on social media, but people are
Yeah.
maybe thinking it's a bit more than usual.
People looking into these things, it's not really relevant. He's not really one that posts loads on social media anyway. Me being around him, he doesn't even, it's not even him po making his posts. He's got media guys that are doing the posts anyway. He's not really bothered about social media. Like, even when I was with him, he said, I ain't been on Instagram for about 4 months. You know what I mean? He just gets a media guy to put a post out, and that's that. He's not really too bothered about all that. So the people can, say what they want or speculate this and that, but I don't think it's that deep.
From someone who's been in his camp, I obviously watched the face-to-face he did with Usyk, and they was talking about how Tyson said he was training for 12 weeks for Ngannou, and he was like, please, come on, obviously, I only need, what, I think 4 weeks of sparring and a week rest, as he said. Obviously,
Yeah.
you've been in there with it. Did he usually go for 12 weeks, 5 weeks? What, does he sort of having us on here? What is the deal?
To be honest, he does usually do about 6 weeks of sparring, and he's good to go. I think that's what I've seen from the last two camps I was in. He's always just training, because he says, likes to train to keep him mentally as well as physically in a good place. But I think he's very experienced. He does 6 weeks of hard sparring, and he's ready to go. He's very experienced. He doesn't feel like he needs as long sparring camps. Gets the 6 weeks in, gets sharp, and gets in there. He's been fighting all his life, so he might not need as long as someone that's not as experienced. He only knows how he feels. So yeah, that's believable from what I've seen. He has ramped up 6 weeks of sparring and got in there.
Something that came out after that Francis fight was I know John Fury was sort of saying, look, Tyson wasn't dialed in, he didn't have a good camp. But when I spoke to you, I believe you've echoed these comments too, is nothing was out of the ordinary. And Tyson said it himself after, he didn't want people to make excuses for him. Everything went as planned. It was just Francis surprised everyone. From someone who was in there, nothing was out of ordinary for the camp, right? Everything was going as planned. It was just Francis gave him a good run for his money. Is that accurate?
Yeah, it's just one of those things. He's training hard, doing the rounds. He's doing 12 rounds sparring. 12 round training sessions. Doing all this stuff that he usually does. It's not like he was saying, "No, I'm not training tonight," or "I'm not doing this many rounds." He was just doing all the usual stuff that he does to prepare.
Some people might say that Francis flight might have been a bit of a blessing, right? Because it's a wake up call, and he might be going into this Usyk one better than ever. Doesn't want a repeat of that last performance. Would you agree with that or not?
Yeah, absolutely. So, if he got in there, took and gone about in a couple of rounds, he wouldn't have maybe felt like he needs to do as much for this next fight. But you realize that, like, when the opponent's on it, you've got to be at your best, and you've got to have every stone unturned. So yeah, of course it's going to motivate him, because at the end of the day, for a fighter, no one cares more about the performance than yourself. So he's gonna think, I need to do better, and I'm gonna do better the next one.
They are very different fights, this Francis and Usyk one, right? Because obviously Francis came in big guy, 265, sort of similar height to Tyson, and now we've got a southpaw in Usyk. He's probably not going to be any more than the 220 mark, and I'm guessing you see it going a very different way. It's going to be very different stylistically compared to the last one, correct?
Yeah, absolutely. It's going to be a much more engaging, I think, in terms of boxing with each other, the boxing and working off each other, countering. I think Tyson's going to let his hands go more because I think he'll feel he can gamble more with the size difference over Usyk, feeling like he's not going to get, hit by one shot that's going to put him down. He's going to let his hands go, throw the combinations, put the pressure on. He's not going to feel as dangerous, but Usyk's exceptional boxer. He's going to be moving around, picking his angles, picking his range and everything. It's going to be a very high caliber boxing fight.
Some an outlook that sort of Tyson had, I watched his recent interview with DAZN, was saying that, yes, this is the first undisputed heavyweight title fight since what 1999, but he just looks at it as another fight. The belts are sort of meaningless. He's been a champion time and time again. Is that sort of an outlook? Maybe you again, big fight for you last time. You can sort of see what he why he puts himself in the situation. Just say, look, you're only as good as your last fight. That's how I'm looking at this one.
Yeah, that's how you've got to be in boxing. You've got to just focus on what the task is at hand and getting that done, because the rest of it will take care of itself. If you keep performing and keep winning, the titles and everything else, they're gonna come in the background. So yeah, like you say, he's just gonna focus on the task at hand, which is winning that fight.
We always hear the saying, a good big un beats a good little un. And
Yeah.
is that what you're sort of looking at this one like? Obviously, Usyk is very, very good in his own sense, but Tyson is just what he's going to be about 50, almost 60 pounds heavier on the night, correct?
Like you say, I've said, I think they're both very skillful, very very good engines, very high IQ boxers, but the size difference that could be the difference with all things level. But it's gonna be a good fight. It's gonna be a seriously highly contested matchup.
And obviously, a few weeks after that, we've got AJ Ngannou. A lot of people sort of think that after that one with Fury, that they figured Francis out. He's not really going to show much difference. But they wrote him off the first time. Do you think it'd be silly to write him off in this one with AJ?
Yeah, you got a big man like that that can punch like that. He's not as familiar in a boxing ring, but he knows how to fight. You can never write him off, but Joshua should do the job, comfortably, with the level of experience. But so should have, the last one, with Fury. But so I'm not gonna really comment, man. I can't comment on these MMA guys because you just don't know what's gonna happen, man.
Judging things go to plan for both of the Brits, do you think we will finally see AJ Fury? It's been so long, we've been waiting for this almost, what, 10 years? And if that does happen, how do you see that one going? Because Joshua, again, looked good in his last fight. If he looks good against Ngannou, everyone's going to say he's sort of reinvented himself under Ben Davison, and it better
Yeah.
late than ever for this fight to happen, right?
Yeah, potentially. If you really look at it, beating Ngannou doesn't warrant an undisputed title shot, does it? You've got guys that have got themselves in the number one contention with these governing bodies that, deserve title shots as well. But obviously it's more of a name fight, isn't it? And the fight that people want for this generation of boxing. So you have to see what the powers be. You never know if Fury could win this fight and retire. It could be that. You know what I mean? If he does that, he'll think he's accomplished everything he can in the game. So we just have to see, because people make these fights and want these fights years in the making and never come about. So we just have to wait and see, to be honest.
And finally, for yourself, I think you got out there 3 times last year, started with this one in Birmingham next month. What's your sort of plans for this year?
Yeah, man, just staying active. Getting this fight done, and I'm gunning for the British title, to be honest. That's what my goal this year is, to by the end of the year, I'm a British champion, still undefeated.